still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. Be still and know that I am God. And so this week we come to the most solemn, quiet week of the year, Holy Week, our final week of preparation before the great feast of Easter. And during this week, we recall a very special moment in the life of Jesus. It was the celebration of his Last Supper. And he wanted to celebrate it with his friends to let them know how much he loved them. This was the Passover. The Jewish people, Jesus's people, celebrated this feast every year with a very special meal. But this year, when Jesus celebrated the Passover, he said words of love that had never been said before. And so here we have the model of the Cenacle. It's the upper room where Jesus celebrated his Last Supper. And just as with every feast there's preparation, so with the feast of Passover, there was a time of preparation. And we hear about it from the Gospel. When the day of the Feast of Unleavened Bread arrived, the day for sacrificing the Passover lamb, Jesus sent out Peter and John. Instructing them, "Go and make preparations for us to eat the Passover." They asked him, "Where do you want us to make the preparations?" And he answered them, "When you go into the city, a man will meet you carrying a jar of water. Follow him into the house that he enters and say to the master of the house, 'The teacher says to you, where is the guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large upper room that is furnished. Make the preparations there." Then they went off and found everything exactly as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover. Chalice for the wine, and a paten for the bread. When it was evening, he came with the 12. While they were eating, he took bread, said the blessing, broke it and gave it to them, and said, "Take it, this is my body." Then he took a cup, gave thanks, and gave it to them, and they all drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which will be shed for many." Then after singing a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Thank you. It was at the Mount of Olives in the Garden of Gethsemane that the soldiers came and arrested Jesus and took him away. And the next day, Jesus died on the cross. But we know this is not the end, because on the third day, Jesus rose from the dead. And the light and life of the risen Christ is stronger than death and stronger than darkness. And this light will never die. Jesus is risen. And he promises to be with us in the bread that becomes his body and the wine that becomes his blood. Jesus, the good shepherd, laid down his life for his sheep. He gives himself completely. And Jesus, the good shepherd, calls his sheep by name, calling them to the Mass, where he continues to give himself completely to his sheep. This is my body. This is my blood. Good Shepherd, come. Lord Jesus, come. The bread is on the table. Lead me to Good Shepherd, come. Lord Jesus, come. The wine is on the table. Lead me to you. And though right now we're not able to come together around the altar for Holy Mass, we will soon once again. And even now we can remember, every day all throughout the world, priests are offering the Mass, and Jesus is present in the bread and the wine that have become his body and blood. And so for now we wait, that we can come together and bring Jesus into our hearts, the good shepherd who gives himself completely for the sheep. What might we say to our good shepherd for this great gift of the Eucharist?